Well, you done me in your bed, I felt it. I tried to be chill, but you're so hot that I melted. I fell right through the cracks, and I'm trying to get back. Before the cool done run out, I'll be giving it my bestest, and nothing's gonna stop me but divine intervention. I reckon it's again my turn to win some or learn some, but I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm yours. Well, open up your mind and see like me. Open up your plans and damn, you're free. Look into your heart and you'll find love, 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 love. Listen to the music of the moment, people dance and sing. We're just one big family. It's your God-forsaken right to be loved, love, 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 loved.
So, we met in high school. We have a circle of friends, I guess. So, in my sophomore year, I did a play or a musical, and one of the main characters in the musical happened to be a friend of Jacob's. And so, because we became close with the other guy, Jacob just ended up being incorporated in the circle of friends. So we were just kind of acquaintances for a while.
I've been spending way too long checking my tone in the mirror and bending over backwards just to try to see it clearer. But my breath fogged up the glass, and so I drew a new face and laughed. I guess what I'll be saying is there ain't no better reason to rid yourself of vanity and just go with the seasons. It's what we aim to do. Our name is...
You know, honestly, when I saw her the first time, I thought she looked really familiar. I didn't think I'd ever met her, but she looked super familiar, like I knew her from someplace, and so it really rattled me. I mean, I would sit there and eat and stare at her, like, pretty creepily, I'm sure, but but I swear I had met her, talked to her at some point, but, you know, we talked and never really crossed paths at all. And so my first thought was, like, how the heck do I know this girl? but I thought she was alright, kind of just a girl.
He was the shy, goofy looking kid. Like, I don't know, he was funny, but he was just kind of the shy kid who didn't talk very much.
So it was my 16th birthday, she asked me out. I remember walking out the house, and Mom was like, "Oh, come home with a date," just totally joking. And then I was sitting at the lunch table and she asked me, or I guess Amy, her friend, asked me for her. But we went to one of my friend's house and just had like this potluck dinner. Everybody brought something, they cooked chicken, and then we played sardines outside, and they ended up, like, we ended up wandering for like hours because that friend's house, and then his date, they locked themselves in a garage, and so JoDee and I had lots of time just to walk around outside and talk, I guess, and then we just kind of all went inside and played Guitar Hero and played a game, and it wasn't bad. It was a lot of fun. I enjoyed it. It was pretty good.
Something that I can't quite explain. I'm so in love with you, you'll never take that away. And if I said it 100 times before, expect 1,000 more. Never take that away. Expect me to be calling you to see if you're okay when I'm not around.
I liked how easy it was to kind of just talk to him. Do I try to make you smile? He just had a different mood or spirit about him, I guess, that kind of
if you're sleeping or you're dreaming, if you're dreaming or you're dreaming of me, I can't believe you actually picked me. I thought that the world had lost its sway. It's so hard sometimes. Then I fell in love with you. That away. And it's not so difficult. The world is not so difficult.
Honestly, it's the way she makes me feel. I feel like a better person when I'm around her. I can really be myself. I don't have to hide something to be embarrassed about who I am or something I'll say. I know that she'll just love me no matter what. I feel like she's very understanding and caring and loving in a way that makes me feel unique and special. She never makes me feel embarrassed or doubt that she loves me. I love the way that no matter what, she makes you feel special, I guess. It's never a dull moment around her, that she always just lifts you up.
I can't believe you actually pay me.
Before we even really started dating, we were kind of hanging out all the time. I had just kind of gotten the feeling that he's the one. But I fought it a lot. And even now, I still sometimes question it. But, I don't know. I think I've known all along that he's the one.
I have to say, like, I don't know, she always brings a good spirit into the conversation or, like, the group. She always kind of takes attention on herself, and she would laugh and just lighten things up, I guess. Not make it boring.
I remember what you wore on the first day. You came into my life and I thought, hey, you know, this could be something.
You say, you know that it all takes my breath away, and now I'm left with nothing.
So maybe it's true that I can't live without you, and maybe two is better than
story. So obviously we started. We knew each other from friends. We were a circle of friends. And junior year, I kind of had a depressing year, and I was kind of a third wheel a lot of the year, and I was just kind of sick of it.
One of my really good friends, Jesse, we spent a lot of time together, and then she had to run off and get married and ruin the whole thing. And so her and I were both kind of without a friend. And so we just kind of started spending a lot more time together, and we'd go to my house and play Mario Kart a lot, and I tried to make it look like she was getting close to beating me.
So I decided that I was going to make him fall in love with me. And so then it went, and I just kind of, we had a class together, so we kind of were friends and talking, and I don't know, we started hanging out all the time. I ended up asking him to be, for a choir thing, my dance partner for a choir thing, and so we were seeing each other all the time for that, because we would have practice after school, and so we went, and then I think I knew I was really starting to like him by the end of that, or by the end of that year, and then all through the summer we started hanging out more and more.
As our friendship grew, you know, my feelings for her really grew, and I like to think that maybe she liked me, but I was too scared and insecure to think that. And so as time went on, we kept spending more and more time. You know, my dad, he actually, I went up to him one day to ask if she could come over to play Mario Kart. And he just kind of wrapped his arm around my shoulder. And he's like, why, you want to invite your girlfriend over? I'm like, she's not my girlfriend, get lost. What are you doing? And he's like, well, you could have picked worse, you know. And it was then that it really hit me that, you know, maybe there's something, you know, maybe I do really like her. It's true.
Playing Mario Kart, doing who knows what, and we would always ask each other, who do you like? And he would always like say, oh, this girl, she's blonde hair, blah, 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 and I was like, whatever. I'm so much prettier, just kidding. But, just kind of always, we kind of alluded to that we liked each other, but didn't really want to say that we liked each other, like that awkward high school couple.
And so she invited me to an award party at the Meridian Pool, and we were swimming. I knew she hated heights, and I knew she would never go off the high dive. And she always kept pestering me about how or who I liked. And so I decided, you know, if you jump off the high dive, I'll tell you who I like. You know, I was being serious about that and thinking she'd never go off the high dive.
So it was kind of a lot of convincing in order for me to go off the high dive. But I finally did, so I went off the high dive.
And then my just swallowed my heart. It's just like, oh crap, I gotta tell her.
And then he was like, I'm not gonna tell you who I like until you ask. And so I was like, in this war, do I ask him who he likes? Because what if it's not me? And then what if it is me? Like, what are we gonna do about that? And I don't know, so he drove me home, and so we're sitting in his truck, and he's just like, so do you want to know? And I was like, no. And I'm sitting there just thinking. And then finally I just turned to him and I asked, so who do you like?
And I was like, oh, I like you. You know, like hoping that she maybe liked me, you know. And it became really awkward because she did like me. And then we're just like, well, what do we do now? Like, where do we go from here?
kind of just talked about where do we go from there, because you can't really steady date, but that's what we ended up doing anyways. But so that was fun. And then senior year came around and we were dating, and I was conflicted because I was like, no, we can't be dating in high school. Like, that's not good. I'm not supposed to be serious with anyone.
As the time went on, I really felt the difference. I really felt like I loved her and cared for her. And then I found out, like, that I really felt like she was the one. I had many instances where I just received confirmation that she was the one, I thought, anyway.
Then we both prepared to go on missions because the age change happened, and I was deciding to go on a mission. And then we came home and had to prepare again to go back out, so that was fun.
You know, we persevered and pushed through it, and JoDee was such a good example in keeping us on the straight. And we finally went out on missions, and you know, it's long distance relationships, they're really hard. They're not easy, but we made it work.
But I don't know, our relationship has had a lot of its rocky moments, and a lot of times where we didn't think it would work out, especially after the second time going back out and him coming home, and that was fun. Anyways.
As soon as I saw her in the airport, I knew that I wanted to keep her going. I wanted to be with her. You know, I was willing to do anything to try to do that. And, you know, as I spent more time with her after our mission, it seemed right. It really felt right. And I went to the temple and I prayed about it and really received an answer that she was the one. And so it was just working together to try to get to the point where we both felt like we were ready for marriage and excited for it, I guess.
But here we are, and it's been a good journey.